Good morning. Today we're going to discuss the differences between weight and mass.
Hey guys.
Hey Bob.
Hi Bob.
Flippin' physics.
Weight and mass are most certainly not the same. However, they are often used interchangeably. Bo, what are the base SI dimensions for mass?
It's kilograms, right?
That is correct. The base SI, or metric system dimension for mass, is kilograms. Weight is also called the force of gravity because it's the force of attraction between the Earth and an object. Therefore, weight is a force and will have the dimensions of force. Bobby, what is the SI dimension for force?
The Newton.
Correct. The SI dimension for force is the Newton. Billy, what is a Newton in base SI dimensions?
A Newton is a kilogram meter per second squared.
1 newton equals 1 kilogram multiplied by 1 meter per second squared. Mass is in kilograms, weight is in newtons. Newtons are clearly not the same thing as kilograms, therefore weight is clearly not the same thing as mass. However, sometimes in the media, weight will be given in kilograms, which we know cannot be correct. Here are some examples. From NASA's website about the Saturn V rocket. Fully fueled for liftoff, the Saturn V weighed 2.8 million kilograms. That's right, from NASA, weight in kilograms. From the book Physics of the Impossible by Michio Kaku, a famous theoretical physicist and best-selling author, he refers to the Earth as a planet that weighs over 6 trillion trillion kilograms. And Derek Muller of Veritasium, who said in one of his YouTube videos,
21 grams. That is the mass of all of the electrons in your body. If, like me, you weigh about 70 kilograms.
Whoops.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, if I were a best-selling author or had more than 100 million video views on YouTube, perhaps then other people would find my small mistakes and refer to them in their videos.
That's a good idea.
So dimensions are one difference between weight and mass. There are two other differences we need to talk about. Anybody have ideas for other differences between weight and mass? Bobby?
The force of gravity, or weight, is always downward, so weight is a vector. However, mass doesn't have direction because it's a scalar.
Yes, Bobby, weight is a vector and mass is a scalar. Therefore, weight has both magnitude and direction, whereas mass has magnitude only. It does not have direction. One more difference. Billy?
I think your weight changes if you go to a different planet, but your mass doesn't change.
That is correct, Billy. Mass is an intrinsic property, which means it only depends on itself. It is an inherent property of the object, whereas weight is an extrinsic property, which means that weight is actually also determined by something external to the object. But what is it that's external to the object that helps to determine the weight of an object?
Well, the equation for weight, or the force of gravity, is that it equals the mass of the object times the acceleration due to gravity. So the weight of an object would depend on little g, the acceleration due to gravity.
And Bobby, what is the accepted value for the acceleration due to gravity here on planet Earth?
Positive 9.81 meters per second squared, and I'm absolutely positive that it's a positive number.
Because I have a mass of roughly 70 kilograms, I have a weight on Earth of about 690 newtons, or about 155 pounds. If I were standing on the moon, my mass would still be 70 kilograms. However, my weight would be about 110 newtons, or about 26 pounds. Notice that my mass is the same. However, my weight changes because I am no longer on the surface of the Earth. It is the almost constant value of the acceleration due to gravity here on planet Earth that makes us often use weight and mass interchangeably. Little g on the surface of the planet, at its most extremes, only varies from 9.78 to 9.83 meters per second squared. But for most of us, we really experience a constant acceleration at 9.81 meters per second squared because we're always just here.
We humans pretty much just hang out on the surface of the planet all of our lives.
Yeah, but I look forward to a day when space elevators are in frequent use by Earth's citizens, and we get to experience changes in the acceleration due to gravity as we ride up to the space stations, and as we ride back down from the space stations. And then we get to experience changes in our weight frequently. And perhaps then people won't confuse weight and mass so often. Ah, it's a dream. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.